Toy Story number 4 from 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, we got the final installment in the Toy Story franchise that is currently out right now, coming at you guys on the channel here today. I don't think there is any other Toy Stories coming out as of right now. There's nothing confirmed. Maybe there will be in the future. I know we have the, I think there's a movie coming out called Lightyear. Obviously a Buzz Lightyear spinoff of this that's supposed to come out sometime this year. But other than that, I think this is pretty much it for the Toy Story franchise as of this point in time, man. And it's been one hell of a journey. It's been one hell of a ride, but I'm excited to see how we cap this off. Now, I will say, as I mentioned at the end of my last reaction, Toy Story 3 for me personally, and after I've seen some comments from you guys, seems like you guys feel the same way, that Toy Story 3 seemed like the perfect way to kind of cap off the series, right? And just end it right there. And then they came out with number 4. And from what I've heard from you guys, you all say number 4 is pretty damn good too, man, which is very surprising to me because I feel like normally when you have a fan base agree that a certain movie should be the last one, that normally if they release something after that, it's not too well received. But for this to be well received even after the way we ended last one, I'm excited to see how this goes. I have absolutely zero idea what this is gonna be, man. Like, obviously with the other ones, we knew he was with Andy and stuff. We knew all the toys were with Andy and whatnot. And we did do different stuff that I didn't know we were going to do in the movies, but, you know, we were with Andy. For this one, I don't know what the fuck is going to happen, man. I don't know if we're going to maybe have Andy come back from college and see the toys again. I don't know if we're just going to be going with Bonnie now, the kid that Andy left his toys with. I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm here for it. I'm excited for it. I have heard the animation in this is a step up from the others as well. Obviously, 2019, lots of development in CGI and everything like that. So I'm excited to see how this goes, man. I'm excited to finish off this series. Like I said, in my Toy Story 1 reaction, once we do finish this, we are going to be jumping into some more animated movies. We'll do another poll over on Patreon. Probably have How to Train Your Dragon in it and have Rango come back and make a return as well, because I know you guys want to see me react to those. And obviously, we'll have two more in that poll. But regardless, guys, we're going to go ahead. We're going to hop into this movie. Before we do, I do ask, if you guys are new to the channel, you do hit that subscribe button. Comment down below what you guys want to see next, man. Drop a like on the video for your boy. Full reaction will be up on Patreon as well as early access to a bunch of other stuff I'm doing. If you guys want to check that out, link in the description down below. We're gonna go ahead, we're gonna hop into this movie. I am sad to be ending this series, but I am excited to start something new, because, man, all these animated movies we've been doing on the channel, Shrek, Kung Fu Panda, this, they've been nothing short of fantastic, man. I've loved them. Kung Fu Panda's probably my favorite out of the animated movies we've done thus far, but all of them are top notch.
Do you see him?
No.
Well, he's done for.
He'll be lost forever.
Jesse, Buzz, Slink, Molly's room. The rest of you, stay put.
Who we looking for? Maybe this is just going to be a prequel. Maybe some of the stories from the years we didn't get to see of Andy growing up, right? Because we only saw a quick montage at the end of the last one. That's Bo, right? That's his lady.
Operation Pull Toy.
Slink?
You got it, Woody.
Barbies.
The Barbies. Bro, this type of weather right here, favorite weather in the world, man. Shit's so relaxing, just storming outside like that. But it's gotta be hard rain like that. It can't just be sprinkling. It's gotta be hard rain, thunder, lightning, all of it. Oh shit, look, Slink is the MVP. Come on now, every movie, MVP, MVP, MVP. Shit, ooh! Damn, the monkey's in a barrel, and Bo, look at the extension on him, man. See, that's so creative, I love it. Get on up, bitch. Oh, fuck.
Beautiful. I'm so glad to see this old lamp go to a good home. We've had it since Molly was a baby.
Did she put Bo in the box too? Oh, is this when they were getting rid of the shit? Their stuff?
Woody, it's okay.
What? No, 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 you can't go. What's best for Andy is
Woody.
That-
I'm not Andy's toy.
Molly's. This is sad.
Kids lose their toys every day. Sometimes they get left in the yard or put in the wrong box.
You can't go, Woody. Come on. You loyal to Andy. The animation does look great.
Come inside. I can't find Woody.
Yeah, Woody's special for him, man. I guess Bo wasn't in the last movie, huh? So this is why she wasn't? She was giving away? Dude, holy shit. This animation looks amazing. The rain, the water. Wow. The shadows, the lighting. Somebody in the comments told me to watch this movie as if the toys are the parents.
And thinking about that shit based off the other movies, Loki is sad as fuck. It's like when all their kids grow up and end up leaving and stuff.
Boy, you got a friend in me.
Bring me on!
Yeah, you got a friend in me.
Man, I don't. When I was younger, oh, that was a great transition. Wow. Oh, that's kind of sad. Fuck. Damn. So it's not gonna be a prequel then, huh? Dude, that was a great intro. Holy fuck. I don't think when I was younger I ever had like a favorite. I probably did have a favorite toy, but not like one that I stuck with for years to come, like Woody. You know, like I had some every year, but never that I kept for like 10 plus. That was just like the one, you know? I wonder how life is here for them. Bonnie on his boot now, man. Oh, that's sad, but you know, Bonnie seemed like a good kid. Like I'm kind of happy for them and for her. You know what I mean? Like a bittersweet happiness almost.
Hi, Mayor. Banker. Hi, Ice Cream Man. Hi, Hat Shop Owner. Mailman. And the Sheriff.
Yeah, she created okay, a little town.
Yeehaw. Sheriff Jesse. Giddy up, Bullseye.
Oh, damn. Jesse's going to be the main one, huh? She don't want to play with Woody. I mean, it makes sense kind of because Jesse's the girl version of him. But that's sad. That girl on that last shot that was sitting at the circle table, I think it was on the right hand side. She had pigtails, bro. She looked like the girl from Monsters, Inc. No? Yes, I've seen Monsters, Inc., guys. Okay? I've seen the first and second one. Oh my god, Primate's seen a movie. Yeah. Bro, imagine if any toys ever got caught moving. That shit would probably freak the fuck out of people, huh? I mean, Sid saw it. He's probably scarred from that. We seen he was a fucking the garbage truck driver last movie. She gonna make a toy? Imagine this toy ends up being able to talk too. That'd be kind of crazy. That means people could make anything, right? And it could talk. I mean, I guess since it's a toy, technically it should, right?
Hello, I'm Forky. Nice to meet you.
Well, hello, Forky. It's nice to meet you. I'm Miss Wendy.
Woody's happy for her. She made a whole ass new toy and everything and didn't even play with Woody, but Woody's still happy for her, man. Woody's so selfless.
We got this kindergarten thing under control, eh? I can't believe I'm talking to
a It's gonna talk. It's gonna talk. That kind of scared me a little bit. Yeah. Bro, that's insane. So you can make a toy and it would come to life.
No, 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 you're a toy now, Forky. Come on, stop. Stop it. Hey, no, no, no. Come on. Oh. Well, I guess I'll just babysit him till he's used to the room.
He jumps back in the trash. Oh my god, dude, this guy. He's still jumping in the trash.
No, 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 no. Big girl's scary.
That probably feels good for Woody, man. I love how Woody's character is so consistent throughout all the movies. He's literally a fucking ride or die for like his owner, you know what I mean? Like, he never abandons them or turns against them, even if it means him not being played with and stuff, you know, or something that makes him unhappy.
You need help with him on the road trip?
No, I got it.
We'll just be stuck in an RV. He can't get far. I got this.
I mean, if he jumps out the window. This is interesting seeing this with like a whole new cast. Not whole new cast, but a bunch of new characters.
Oh my god, dude.
You guys like going on road trips? You guys prefer road trips or just flying? If you're going to a place.
You doing okay? I don't know, Buzz. I know you weren't around when Andy was little, but I don't remember it being this hard.
Because your toys weren't running away. Jumping in the trash.
That little voice inside me would never leave me alone if I gave up.
Yeah, but you need sleep.
Who do you think it is? Who? The voice inside of you. Who do you think it is?
It's your conscience.
Me? You know my conscience? Tells you things? What you're really thinking? Fascinating. Advises you. What?
No, not the... I love Buzz. Oh my god, dude.
Freedom!
Oh my god, dude.
Pam, how far
Yo,
do I
he
need
got
to stop?
Blown
5.32
far.
Miles, give or take.
I can make that. I'll meet you at the RV park.
He's gonna jump out and then go all that way. 5.32 miles? Bro, how long do you think it would take him to go that far? I mean, I guess he could catch a ride on a car or something, but we're in the middle of nowhere. Like, if we're talking him just walking, bro, 5.32 miles on them little ass legs, bro. That's gotta take days, right? Not only that, but you gotta find Forky out here? Sheesh.
Carrie?
What the fuck?
No.
Why do I have to be a toy?
Because you have Bonnie's name written on the bottom of your sticks.
Andy's room was a planet? Wow. That is messed up.
Right. That's exactly what I thought when he first showed
bro,
up.
Bro, this is awesome. He's going to learn how to actually be a toy and stuff. This is cool. Just like in the first movie, look, he's carrying him now. Just like in the first movie, he had to teach Buzz that he was a toy. Now he's going to teach him that he's a toy and what it means to be a toy.
Don't get me wrong, you still feel good about it, but then somehow you find yourself after all those years sitting in a closet, just feeling
useless.
Yeah.
Your purpose fulfilled?
Exactly.
That speech given by Woody, man, it is sad, especially when, if you look at it from the perspective like that, the toys are supposed to be like the parents, kind of, you know? Like when the kid grows up, goes off to college, does their own thing in life and stuff. You know, you're happy for him, but you're also sad because you don't get to experience any of that stuff. Oh, is this going to be Bo? Maybe? Is that the light from his sister's room? From Molly's room? That's why they showed that backstory. Bo might not even be in there. She might have, you know, got the lamp alone without Bo. It might be a completely different lamp, you know, that's the same like model but different.
Why, you're not a bother at all. We were just out for my early morning stroll. And look, we met you. My name is Gabby, and this is my very good friend, Benson.
Bro, Gabby looks like a fucking knockoff Annabelle, kind of. And Benson looked creepy as fuck, man. These people are definitely holding Bo captive, prisoner. Hostage, all the above.
You have a voice box like me. Benson, show him.
Oh, maybe Benson needs a voice box.
I'm Gabby, and I love you.
Wow, you need to fix that.
Her voice box is fucked up. She's gonna take Woody's.
We can't stay.
Yes, you can.
Oh, God. I knew it, bro. This place is creepy as fuck. Bro, they do a good job of making creepy ass dolls. Like in what was it? The first one was Sid. That's smart.
Mom, she has enough toys from the store.
Oh, it's fine. Nobody buys the toys anyway.
Oh no, dude. Woody's getting taken away from there though, and from away from Forky.
It's a secret mission in uncharted space. Let's go.
I think,
go on a mission to rescue him.
Go.
Where are you going? Why?
Should we all go? Are we going?
No time to explain. Attack!
No time to explain.
Hey.
Oh no!
Okay. Everyone jumping out the window.
Yeah, and what's your plan, Buzz? Like, you don't even know where he's at this point, man. Oh, he is gonna see him here because the little girl has to go to the carnival. Wow.
The slingshot maneuver is all we've got. Full speed ahead.
He's gonna slingshot off that somehow. Inner voice. That's right. He thinks that's his conscience. Oh my god. Oh my god. Dude, this movie looks fucking amazing. Like the animation, I can't get over it, bro. Look at him gliding too. Oh shit. Damn. That was almost clean. Ooh. Oh no, dude. Somebody gonna win him, bro. Damn. All we're doing is making shit worse, getting ourselves captured, trying to save fucking Forky.
Oh, baby, it's a good day to play, huh? Am I right?
He's going back up the slide just to keep coming back down. That's funny. Those were the three sheep, right? Those were both sheep.
Do you like riding horses?
It is her. Wow, that's crazy. And they can't even say anything to each other right now. Damn. Yeah. She said, keep your ass down. She know how to make her way around this place, huh? Damn, so Belle wasn't even in the shop. She probably was originally, but the little girl probably took her.
Wait, you're a lost toy? That's awful.
That's great, huh?
Damn. I mean, awfully great that you are lost out here. Skunk. Skunk! Skunk!
Watch out!
Oh, shit.
Huh?
I told you not to drive so fast. You almost ran him over.
Oh, shit. That's dope. She probably uses that for safety out here because she's a lost toy. She doesn't have a home.
Gus? Lefty?
Billy Goat and Gruff?
Right. Sorry, guys.
Girls!
Got everything wrong.
How long have you been out on your own?
7 fantastic years.
7?
Damn.
You would not believe
she's turned into a savage.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
Carl's getting played with. You guys in?
You bet.
He didn't high five him.
Love this.
So all these lost toys just group up and try and go places where kids play with them, different parks.
Bonnie'll get over it.
No, but you see, Bonnie needs him just like Molly needed you.
Bringing back those emotions and just like Andy needed him.
My harmony is perfect.
Your harmony, bitch. She don't seem to like you.
Forky, it's tea time. It's tea time.
Yoo-hoo!
Maybe that's why she wants a new voice box, so that Harmony will play with her.
Now, about our friend Woody. I want to know everything about him.
Oh yeah, Woody. Yeah. I've known that guy my whole life. 2 days.
Yeah, literally. I was going to say, yeah, right. But then I was like, oh wait, no, he literally has. Oh my god, dude. Like, imagine toys being real for real.
Help me get out of here.
I'll help you. With my foot.
Get him.
Get him.
What are you doing? I can't reach him. Help me out here. Come on.
Oh, sorry, Ducky. I'm not a mind reader, you know.
What's not to understand? You gonna make me say it?
What?
With these tiny legs, I cannot reach without your help.
Oh.
All right? Okay. This.
Jesus, bro.
In the vacuum of space, they cannot reach
Damn. Like, and now he's gonna get pulled out. Wow, I'm talking about
so
luck.
Gravity feel like.
Yeah, that's it.
That's funny. I think they're the first set of toys that we've seen that are stuck together, other than the sheep, right? She probably can fix it.
I'm fine. I'm fine. Don't worry. It happens all the time. Tape.
Damn. So it broke off and they taped it up. That's right. She did have that part bandaged. Man, she's been through some shit over the years, huh?
Oh, I'm sorry, Bo.
Who needs a kid's room when you can
have the world?
All of this.
Yeah. It's like when you're with a kid, you don't have as much freedom, but you have all that love. You know what I mean? That you don't have when you're alone. But when you're alone, you have all this freedom.
The highway exit has to be somewhere.
Look at Buzz. He's right here.
Look out.
Hey!
Good work, Inner Voice.
Dude, I love the fact that he thinks that's his conscience, and it's literally working out for him every single time. Huh? What happened? Did she pop one of the tires?
Just everything is going.
Okay, damn, bro. I'd be livid.
How about we go to the carnival, or maybe check out some of those shops in town?
Hey. Smart on her part.
We're not going anywhere. If you get my point.
That's kind of fucked up too.
Who will Bonnie love more, Ducky or me? Say me.
No, say Ducky.
Bunny.
Okay, guys, playtime is over.
Probably Bunny, but you guys are a package deal, so it wouldn't matter anyway, right?
Move over. You move over. Quit pushing me. Stop.
Oh my.
Hey, girl, that sheep has 3 heads.
No.
What?
All 6 eyes just looked into my soul.
Go ahead.
All 6 eyes just looked into my soul. See what I mean? Bro, they got such a unique personality. A perfect addition for this shit. I love it. It's so funny. She's waiting. She's like, ooh, I'm about to fuck you up.
Oh, where did you two come from?
Well, we're not doing that.
Okay, that didn't actually happen. Damn, bro. I thought they actually did. I was going to say that's the first time we've seen a toy actually like do some shit like that so blatant.
Where is this going?
Shh, don't interrupt.
Yeah, what the fuck? What's happening? What the fuck is happening? Why are we getting a day in the life?
Okay,
right? Uh-huh.
Not gonna happen.
What the fuck? We couldn't have just skipped to that part. Dude, this is awesome, man. I wasn't sure how much I was gonna like this movie because I felt like the third one was a perfect end off for it, but I'm loving it.
Billy, Goat, and Gruff, those are my girls.
He knew all the names and that they were girls.
Please, Mr. Kaboom, this is really important. My kid. You have a kid?
You can't be mentioning a kid around here. Hey, that's kind of dope. Toy's kind of lit, bro.
I was ready to finally do what I was made to do. But when Rajan realized I couldn't jump as far as the toy in the commercial. It's a commercial. It's not real. Rajan threw me away.
That's false advertising. Damn, so he didn't even have that kid for long. That's tough. Maybe he didn't crank you up enough.
Who's the most spectacular daredevil Canada has ever seen?
Kaboom!
Can you do the jump?
Yes, I Canada!
Yes, I Canada. Oh my god, dude. I like that all these movies have good messages in them too, man. You know what I mean? This one telling you be yourself, you know what I mean? Not trying to be something you're not or someone you're not.
Now with the carnival traveling through, it's our chance to hop a ride and leave town.
You're leaving?
Sure am. You ever think about getting out there, seeing the world?
Without a kid? No. You can't teach this old toy new tricks.
You'd be surprised.
This is awesome, man. Her little speech, she was talking about getting out there and seeing the world, man. It's like, you know... It's like the parent that wants their kids grow up, they feel like they can go out and do stuff, you know what I mean? And they don't want to have kids no more, you know? They did the kids raising it, and now they're going to go live their life type thing. And it's awesome that, you know, we're seeing this shit. And they're showing you it's not being, you know, a lost toy isn't as bad as they made it seem like in the other movies, you know? It's all a matter of what you enjoy, what you want to do. She went through the phase of her life of, you know, raising a kid, essentially, and now she wants to live her life. Oh shit.
Huh?
Don't tell me this is gonna fail miserably.
It's not real.
I can't do this.
I'm sorry, Rajan.
No.
Dude, you fucking idiot. They're not gonna have enough space to make it, huh? Ooh. Barely.
What's new, Missy Cat?
Wow.
Take the bunny. I'm too
damn, to man. Yeah, go ahead, Buzz. Fuck these toys up, these little weird-ass, scary-ass puppets. Damn. They gonna tear this man apart. Oh, no, the cat. Shit. Oh, no! Yo, Woody's getting fucked up. Bo should be able to fix him. Yeah, Bo.
Wait, we don't have Forky.
Again? Oh my god, dude. Literally the whole reason we came here.
Buddy!
He's in the box,
buddy!
Huh?
No. Oh, buddy!
It's gonna be okay.
Because it's all I have left to do.
He doesn't get played with no more, man.
I don't have anything else.
So the rest of us don't count?
That's not what I meant. Bonnie needs Forky.
No, you need Bonnie. Open your eyes, Woody. There's plenty of kids out there. It can't be just about the one you're still clinging to.
It's called loyalty. Something a lost toy wouldn't understand.
Damn. Cutting deep, man. That's fucked up. Woody don't get played with no more, you know what I mean? He feels like this is all he can do is focus on the kid and give them happiness and stuff. You know, he doesn't have a life of his own.
I don't leave toys behind, Buzz.
Yeah, but Woody, you're actually
not now? Not ever.
You're leaving
and
them behind.
He left me behind.
Yep.
What now, inner voice?
Mission accomplished. Return to base.
Maybe that means Woody will save Forky himself and they just got to get back themselves since Bonnie's backpack was in there. Maybe he can get Forky and jump in the backpack.
I'd give anything to be loved the way you have.
Time to retire, Woody. Give her your voice box. You can still talk to the toys. Woody, it's not going to kill Woody or nothing. It just means he can't, you know, the snake in my boot shit won't work. But Bonnie never used his pull string really much anyway. Played with him. He's just been left in the closet.
Seth!
He only cares about himself.
No! You're wrong.
Damn.
He's always trying to do right by his kid.
By putting everyone in danger. Ugh. That
whatever
kind of
it takes
crazy
for the kid.
Loyalty, just
you gotta love him for it.
Her and Woody have always had a thing for each other, man. It's like the flame that could have been. You know what I mean? It's the one that got away. I love all the uniqueness in the movies, man. Like, the fact that she drives around a little RC car dressed up as a skunk. You know? Like, shit like that. It's great. They took his box out and sewed him back up.
Yay!
You are my best friend. Let's play all day.
Damn. Wouldn't her voice be just Woody's, though?
You can take it home if you want.
Grandma... Wow. She still didn't want to play with her.
Giffy was supposed to be her toy.
Wow, that is so sad, man. I feel horrible. Oh, it sucks because she just wants to be loved. You know what I mean? Oh, there's so many different messages in these movies, man. I love it. Maybe Woody's going to get her and bring her to Bonnie.
There are plenty of kids out there. And one of them is named Bonnie. She's waiting for you right now. She just doesn't know it yet.
Yep. Bonnie would probably love to play with her.
If you sit on a shelf the rest of your life, you'll never find out, will you?
See, man, good messages like that. You never know unless you make the leap. You gotta take a leap of faith. Look at that, the fireworks in the back. This is his moment to shine, okay? This you ain't gotta flex on him like that. Shot.
Kaboom.
He made it! He was supposed to crash, so hey. It all worked out in the end.
What is happening?
Slow down!
I can't!
Press the brake. I'm trying to press it!
Yo, you're gonna just get us all killed. Fuck! Look, they're recording him.
It's just like you said. This is the most noble thing a toy can do.
She'd be a good toy, man. She just hasn't had love in a while, so, you know, she lost that. But she's good at heart, you know? It's like a good analogy for humans, too, you know? People that get done wrong in life so many times that they just, it changes them, you know? But they're a good person at heart.
I'm Gabby Gabby. Will you be my friend?
I'll help you.
This movie's had a lot of heartwarming moments, man. This is sad, though, for Bo and Woody. They're about to part ways, man. Hey. Bo's not gonna go.
So long, cowboy.
Happy trails.
I hope they all go, man.
Billy, Goat, Gruff, take care of her, girls.
He knows their names and that they're all females now at the end. Man, dude. These movies do such a good job of making you actually care for the fucking toys, you know? Like these inanimate objects.
You sure? Hey, listen to your inner voice.
It's just sad, though, if he splits up from the group. I'm not more so sad about him splitting up from Bonnie. I'm more so sad about him splitting up from the group, you know? You ain't even gonna say bye to Buzz or the rest of the gang, man. You gotta say goodbye to everybody. But at least these two are together, you know? They had a thing from the start and they can finally be happy together, you know what I mean? They don't gotta worry about taking care of kids or nothing. They can just do their own thing. Getting a little choked up, man. Shit. It's sad. Why they gotta fucking do this shot of all of them staring at me? Aw, he's gonna give her the sheriff badge too, man. Oh. Oh man, don't do this to me. Oh. This was sad, man. This one was definitely the most emotional and sad. Like my heart feels a little bit of pain, but also happiness for these two. And happiness for Woody, man. He's been the most loyal toy throughout all these movies, and now he gets to live his life for himself and be happy. You know what I mean?
Woody's a lost toy? He's not lost.
He's found.
Not anymore.
Man, it's sad that...
infinity
and beyond. It's sad. Just the saddest part isn't even him leaving Bonnie because they weren't that close since she never played with him. It's more so him breaking up from the group. Man. But I'm happy that he's with Bo. Man, this shit is sad. You know, and thinking about it from like a parent's perspective too, like as like the toys being the parent and the kids obviously being the kids makes it even more sad, you know what I mean? But also kind of relatable. I mean, I don't have human kids myself. I got two dogs and I treat them as my kids, man. And even for me, seeing them grow up, you know, from puppies, my little Doberman puppy, Athena, she'll be 7 months. She's 7 months this month. And she's grown up fast, man. And my boy Hades, he's going to be 2 in May, and he's grown up fast, too. And they're like my kids, man. You know what I mean? And just seeing them grow up makes me sad. So I can only imagine how it is when you have an actual kid and shit. The animation for this movie is fucking fantastic, though, man. Like, my God. Hey, that's how they're getting the toys out. That's awesome. Getting toys, new homes and stuff, man. Dude, they always do a fantastic job with these credits too, adding in extra things. After 3, the ending felt so perfect that I thought they would just fuck shit up with 4, but 4 was just a nice touch. This movie just complemented the entire series very well. It wrapped stuff up. It gave us some returning characters. It gave us some kind of closure and roundup, I guess, for our characters themselves too and their story. It's awesome, man. I don't know. Feels bittersweet, this ending. I'm excited to get into a new series, but it also feels kind of sad saying goodbye. Plush rush. Oh, shit! Oh,
I like that, huh? You got plush rush, son!
This motherfucker got laser eyes?
Get those knees up!
Get those knees up? Oh, my God! What the fuck? This is all in their head, huh? Dude, these two want world destruction. Holy fuck! Oh my God, talk about imagination.
We can get more toys to kids.
Yeah, let's do that.
I'm glad her and Woody ended up together, you know? And they can just live their lives now. They're done raising kids. They got to do that and experience that, and they're happy about it, and they got those memories and stuff. But now they get to live for themselves and do what they want to do, you know? And not have to worry about all these other responsibilities. A girl knife. Like Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head. She's gonna jump in the trash. That would be funny as fuck if they had her do that. Oh. Jordan Peele was Bunny? Keanu Reeves was Duke. What? He was Duke Kaboom? Keanu Reeves was really in this shit? He was Duke Kaboom? Let me go back and listen to his voice. How did I not hear his voice in that? Where's the part where he talks? Right here, let me see. I don't know, man. It sounds like him, but it doesn't sound like him. The thing is, I've never really seen Keanu in anything other than his live action shit, so I've never heard his voice without looking at his face, man. You know what I mean? So I feel like I can't just distinguish his voice from hearing it. Now, someone like Tom Hanks and Tim Allen, you know, they're a little bit more recognizable. I can definitely hear them in Woody and Buzz, but not this way. I don't know. Toy Story number 4 from 2019 is in the books, ladies and gentlemen, and I just gotta... God, those are some fucking loud claps, but man, what a fucking series. Toy Story as a whole. Fucking fantastic, bro. I'm not gonna lie, you know, going into this movie, after the third one, I was a little skeptical and nervous for this. Granted, you guys had told me all of them were fantastic. I personally felt like 3 was the perfect send-off for this series. And in my mind, I still feel like it is, but 4 just feels like it added so much to it that I didn't know that I needed added. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't know that I wanted to see this storyline for Woody. Like, seeing Woody's story kind of finish off like this feels a lot better than how it finished off in the last movie. You know? And then seeing... I feel like last movie's ending for the toys, like Buzz and all of them, definitely felt better than this one. Just because it, I don't know how to explain it, man. I just felt like this one had a better ending for Woody, so to speak. You know what I mean? I feel like this kind of wrapped up more so his story in it of like, throughout all these movies, he's the most loyal one. He's always focused on Andy throughout all of them. The first one, he's teaching Buzz and bringing Buzz back, even though, you know, he feels threatened by Buzz. He's still bringing him back for Andy. You know what I mean? And then in the second one, he's there for him. you know, in the end, he was originally going to go to the museum, but he still came back for Andy, and he brought new toys with him. Last movie, all the toys wanted to stay at daycare. He was the only one who wanted to go back for Andy, even if it meant staying in the attic. You know what I mean? And then in this one, he's still loyal, and he finally accepts that, you know what? It's time for some me time. It's time to become a lost toy. This thing they talk about throughout all these movies about, you know, getting lost and how it's this horrible thing. But it's not as bad as they make it out to be. You know what I mean? It's like you're essentially kind of freedom, so to speak, you know? And and again, I think I mentioned this during the movie. There's positives and negatives to each one, I guess. But, you know, obviously the whole positive with the kid thing is, you know, you get to feel extremely loved by somebody, you know, and you get to feel extremely loved by this kid and bring them so much joy and happiness. But on the downside to that, you also, you know, you're stuck just sitting there waiting for them to come home. You know, you could get put in storage, you could get, you know, lost, you could get taken to daycare, you could get given away, you could get broken and stuff, but you get to experience that love, man. And then when, you know, you're on the side of things where Bo's at, essentially where she's a lost toy, you don't feel that love from the kids and stuff like that, but you get your freedom, you get to experience the world, you get to do stuff for you, you get to do stuff you want to enjoy. You know what I mean? And like, when I read, because I had read the comment actually like yesterday from recording this, where somebody said to, you know, think of when you're thinking about these Toy Story movies, think about them from like the toys perspective is like the parents' perspective. And yeah, for some moments that's definitely true, some moments not, but like a lot of moments in this movie I feel like it was, you know, with this whole thing about Woody finally letting go of that connection to the kid and feeling like he needs to be there for them 24/7 and raise them still and you know, do all this stuff for them. And now he can just kind of take a step back and focus on his life a little bit, you know? And that's kind of cool, man. And I just, all these movies had great messages in them. They had stuff for the kids. They had stuff for, you know, teens. They had stuff for adults. It was a fantastic series, man. All these animated movies that I've been checking out recently have fucking surprised me to no end. Shrek, this. Kung Fu Panda definitely is still my favorite that I've checked out thus far, man. But like, I can only imagine what we still have to see. Like I said, we are going to be doing a poll over on Patreon to determine what we do next. I know a lot of people have been asking for How to Train Your Dragon. A lot of people have been asking for Django or for Rango or whatever it's called. The one with Johnny Depp. I think it's just Rango. And there's so many animated movies out there. And I've seen some of them, but there's also a lot I haven't seen. Like I said, guys, we are going to be doing a poll over on Patreon to determine what we check out next. If you are watching this over on Patreon, the poll is either up already or it will be going up in the next couple of days. But guys, let me know what you thought about it in the comment section down below. Like always, if you guys did enjoy this reaction video, make sure to leave a like. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Full reaction will be up on Patreon, as well as early access to a bunch of other stuff I'm doing. If you guys want to check that out, link in the description down below. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. What is going on, everybody? I hope you guys all did enjoy that video you just checked out. If you did, make sure to drop a like and comment down below. What is a movie or TV series that you guys would like to see me react to next? Want to give a couple quick shout-outs to some of my highest tier supporters over on Patreon, man. Shout-out to the homie That's So Gordo, the homie Silas Kane, and the homie Alexander Collins. I appreciate your guys' insane support, man. If you guys want to join the Patreon family, link is on screen right now as well as in the description down below. I hope you guys all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one.